So people may wonder how and why psychology relates to pain. And I think a really nice place for understanding how pain relates to psychology is to consider the definition of pain from the International Association for the Study of Pain. And the definition that they give of pain is that pain is both a sensory and an emotional experience. And so psychology is actually built into the very definition of pain. And it turns out that how we think and how we feel profoundly influences our experience of pain itself. And this is how psychology relates to pain, but also if we have an existing psychological condition like anxiety or depression, that's going to impact our experience of pain. And it can also impact how we respond to pain treatments. So our sort of pre-existing psychological state has this impact on pain. But then also think about pain, chronic pain in particular, is very stressful. And the experience of living with daily pain can also trigger the experience of anxiety. It can trigger feelings of depression or symptoms of depression. So the pain itself, actually living with pain, can generate some of these symptoms. A lot of people who have chronic pain may have disruptions in their sleep, and that can lead people to feel anxious. It can lead to mood changes. It can lead to increases in pain intensity the next day. So, how a person is experiencing their psychological state will have that impact on pain. And then pain itself can generate some of these psychological issues that then feed back into the experience of pain. And so you can begin to see that pain and psychology are actually intimately related. And for that reason, it's important that we investigate these factors in terms of treating people who have chronic pain. And so this is where pain psychology comes in, and this is where pain psychologists have a role in the multidisciplinary treatment of pain, which is really the gold standard approach. We want to approach pain from different angles. There's certainly the medical side, there's also physical therapy, the physical side, and maybe some complementary and alternative treatments, and psychology as well. So we'll take a look at all of these factors. We examine how well people are coping with their pain, what sort of strategies people use to help them cope with their pain, with the experience of pain. And it turns out that a lot of times people are unwittingly contributing to their pain experience. Not because they want more pain, but because they simply don't have the right knowledge and the right skills to be able to turn down the volume on their pain. So it's almost like if you think about pain as being the volume on a radio, we can either dial up or dial down pain based on how we are responding to it. And so we're not really born knowing how to do this and how this all fits together. All we know is that when we experience pain, it's uncomfortable, it's something we want to get away from, it's something that generates anxiety and stress. But we're not born knowing what to do about that. So it really comes down to learning the right information, the right skill sets that are going to be beneficial, that are going to turn down the volume of the pain and basically increase comfort and well-being and a sense of control over one's pain. And indeed, it's not just learning how to have a better sense of control. You actually are acquiring better control over your pain. And so this is something that pain psychologists do. We teach people various skill sets to help them turn down the volume on their pain. And what's nice about that is that it puts the patient in the driver's seat. It puts the person living with chronic pain in the driver's seat of their own experience. And that turns out to be very powerful medicine. It's very powerful medicine, not just in terms of treating pain, but also in terms of putting a container around anxiety and depression. And so people basically are able to gain a better quality of life all the way around, better psychological experience. And so this is really nice. This is one of the goals of good pain treatment. And so in the research domain, we want to improve upon what we know already works. We already know that when people are coping better, they have less pain, they have better responses to pain treatments. But we can do better than existing treatments and existing knowledge. And this is why it's important to research these factors. We're trying to tease apart some of the mechanisms of how this works, you know, in the brain, in the body. We're looking at different mediators for how these skill sets that show how these skill sets are beneficial and why these skill sets are beneficial. And so we may do research looking at the immune system, for instance, and how our thoughts and our feelings may be linked to an immune response that could either worsen pain or improve pain. And so this is just one example of the type of research that we do, linking psychology to physiology, to the sensory experience of pain. And so there's some really exciting research happening now, and here at Stanford, we are excited to be a part of that process in moving the field forward.
The preceding program is copyrighted by the Board of Trustees of the Leland Stanford Junior University. Please visit us at med.stanford.edu.